Kids love digging in the dirt, of course. Adult kids do too. Getting those young minds to embrace their green thumb, that is a fun way to get them to learn about science, art, and patience. Joining us is Alise McGregor. She's owner of Little Newton's Early Education Center. She's here with some great ideas to get the kids involved with gardening, because we know so many of us adults love to get out and toil in the soil.
Yes, and I think that it's a great opportunity for a family to start gardening with their children.
Right.
Because like you said, adults love it. So if you can get your children interested in it at a young age,
right,
it can be a fun project for your family. Also, it's great to get them outside and get them, you know, learning as well as expending
right
some energy.
They can get dirty and they don't get in trouble for it.
That's exactly
yeah
right.
Yeah.
Which brings me to my dirt. So one fun thing that you can do is incorporate math with, you know, planting the flowers. They can do a fourth a cup, half a cup.
Oh.
They can, you know, learn the different quantities of the dirt
mm-hmm
with a measuring cup. Very simple, and the kids enjoy getting their hands dirty with that.
Yeah. And planted a little marigold there.
Yeah. And then after the flowers planted, I have a watering chart here. This is something that can help them get involved in the planting. It also kind of teaches patience. They're watching, you know, their flower grow or how often they're watering.
Right. Well, and that's good to teach them also not to overwater
yeah
or underwater. I could use something like this.
Well, and I was thinking for parents, it's great too,
sure,
because then your child is now helping you with
a little chore that
yeah
maybe, yeah, they didn't even know it was a chore.
Yep, and that's fun. This is one of the arts that we do that is related to gardening, and it's very simple. It's painting the toilet paper roll
mm-hmm
and helping your child cut it in the different areas,
and
it makes
a flower.
Yeah, it makes a nice little flower.
Mm-hmm. Did you do this work yourself, Alise? That's very lovely.
I know, isn't
it's very nice
nice.
Yeah.
And then you could also take the opportunity to teach them, and same with this one where we have the different types of a flower. This is something that's used with pushpins, so it's traced out.
Oh, right,
then,
I remember all that.
Yeah.
The pistil, the stamen, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's an opportunity to teach them as well as, you know, they get their hands.
The mechanics of a flower,
yes,
right there.
Fine motor.
What do we have here?
So this is a, it's actually a puzzle, but it's teaching them, you could do it as a memory game and then spin
oh
them around and match them up.
Mm-hmm.
Another way to teach them while yeah they're doing fine motor.
Stem, leaves, flower, like that.
Same with the flashcards, talks about the soil, seeds, rain, you know, the seedling grows
yeah
and then the plant.
And the visuals to go with it, which
yep
is how we, so many of us learn.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then the, that's for older children, but it's something, another opportunity to teach while they're doing some form of art.
Right. All fun
yes
stuff.
Yes. And then I also brought a few books. My kids like to sit down and just look at different types of flowers
sure
and it engages
some,
them.
And pretty pictures. Nothing
yes
wrong with that.
Exactly.
Nothing wrong with that. Alise McGregor, thanks for being here. Some great ideas to get the kids involved with some gardening. Good
yes
stuff. Thanks so
thank
much.
Thank you.